peace. This your host, Tila Shalom, and this is the Kazman Teachings in the words of Jehovah and his angel ambassadors from the Kazman Bible, Owaspe. And the topic of discussion today is called the Battle of 1,000 Years. And these are the battles of the gods for the dominion of the earth and the lowest heavens. And these were called battles of 1,000 years. And the time period is within 3753 BC to 2753 BC is the times of these wars. Now here are the armies of Dias that went down to the earth to inspire mortals to battle in overthrowing the worshippers of the great spirit Jehovah for a period of 1,000 years. Now, Book of Wars Against Jehovah, chapter 16, verse 29 through 35 states, Dias then departed to the council chamber and took his seat on the throne. The guests and gods and counselors entered the south gate and went and stood in the midst of the floor of the chamber. Whereupon the Lord God saluted them, warriors of gods, and they embraced in the sign of Taurus, signifying to enforce righteousness. For the image of a bull was one of the signs above the throne, and this was called the Edict of Bull. Verse 30. These then are the names of the gods and goddesses with their generals and captains that were empowered in heaven to go down to the earth to subjugate it unto the Lord God, the false. That is to say, verse 31, the gods were Anubis, Hakas, now called Tien, Wachasaj, now called Sudga, Chilimung, now called Osiris, Baal, Ashtaroth, Phobi, Heslo, Helo, Orion, Hebe, Valish. Verse 32, their generals were Hoin, Oda, Ja, Noeth, Jun, Platonia, Loshang, Waka, Poseidon, Doshtu, Ugaroth, Nuth, Apalia, Suts, Karyusa, Mayan, Fia Yestai, Petorus, Ban, Hojoya, Mungo, Mungo Joe, Urana, Okeanos, Egypt, Hirim, Tikrono, Ares, Ubi, Phetas, Don, Dan, Elijah, Sol, Samern, the Wawach, Haya, Aphrodite, Han, Wheel, Hang Li, Wang Li, Artemis, Gasangya, Loatha, Pu, Tuchin Watugo, Ben, Arin, Naswichi, Gaia, Tisin, Argo, Hadar, Atstisel, Ishang, Daridrat, Udan, Nadar, Bagwai, Shiyuga, Brahat, Zeman, Asring, Oib, Shanglong, Sasha, Jigate, Atyina, and Du. Verse 33. Their captains were Penbu, Josh, Yam Yam, Holisu, Youth, Gamba, Sed, Drata, Yupset, Wag, Mar, Luth, Maka, Chutz, Hiraktu, Vesinu, Hasuk, Truth, Medyar, Pathmedin, Cope, Sipentamanius, Trastaya, Peter, Hoab, Vanyata, Cryosha, Visper, Siam, Plauya, Yaktaroth, Abua, Zoatha, Kakankat, Hovian, Maslo, Haura, Abel, Openasta, Isaiah, Vasta, Patanas, Cairo, Waskador, Uvash, Ashisnogo, Kavo, Kalamalahudan, Lutrum, Wab, Daira, Kus, Sumango, and Liwan. Verse 34. Besides these, there were 1,000 officers of lower rank. And now, when they were sealed as to rank and place and allotment, they withdrew. And Dias gave a day of recreation that the gods with their officers might make the selections from the multitude as for their private soldiers. Verse 35. And in one day's time, the armies were made up, 2,000 million angels, and they departed down to the earth to destroy the faithless and the names of Jehovah and Omazd, and establish Dias, otherwise the Lord God, the false. Now these are the captains and generals of the armies of Dias that will go down to the earth to overthrow the temples and worshippers of Jehovah to establish Dias, the Lord God. Now Book of Wars Against Jehovah, chapter 18, verse 4 through 17 states, verse 4, to win great majesty to himself, and after having sworn to havoc the whole earth in order to establish the name Dias and Lord God, he called to his side his five chief friends, the gods Hikas, falsely named Tien, Wachasaj, falsely named Sudga, Chilimung, falsely named Osiris, Baal, and Ashtaroth. And thus in dignity Dias spoke to them, Verse 5. It is well, my God, ye stand about and see the battles, but let your generals and high captains go forth and mingle in the bloody work. In your kingdoms be constantly uprising your magnificence, and in times sailing forth to the earth valiantly, as when kings and queens and prophets are to win a victory or plunder into mortal death, to show how your august presence turned the tide of battle. Then hide ye back in dignity to your thrones, leaving your officers and inspiring hosts to go in the game of mortal tragedy. Verse 6. Then spoke Osiris, falsely named, saying, to exalt thy name, O Dias, the Lord God, and to persuade mortals that thou of all created beings can stand in Horeb, and by thy will control the victory to whomsoever applaud thee and praise thy name. Be thou to me the bond of my soul oath. So will I lose or win battles on the earth accordingly as they shall honor thee and despise the great spirit or any other god, O Lord. Verse 7. Then Tien, also falsely named, said, to keep mortals in constant war for 1,000 years, to teach them that battle are won or lost according to the loudest call and praise to thee, O Dias, under thy thigh will I be as an oath renewed from everlasting to everlasting. Verse 8. Sudga, the false, said, by all my parts to shape the arms and legs of the unborn in comeliness shall my legions drum to the heirs of a woman 1,000 years, swearing them to the name of Dias, or refusing to curse with crookedness all their progeny. And when these mothers slept, my legions shall find their souls in their dreams and give them delight or torment, accordingly as they, when awoke, applaud thee, my most might Lord God. Verse 9. Baal said, to overturn the oracles of Jehovah and to make the prophets and seers receive and announce thy name, O Dias, the Lord God of heaven and earth, have I already sworn more than 10,000 oaths. Verse 10. Ashtaroth said, the work of my legion shall be to deal death to thy enemies, O Dias. To them that raise the name Jehovah or Omazd or Great Spirit, my legion shall carry foul smells to their nose while they sleep. And for thy enemies who may win a battle against thy people, my legion shall carry inoculation from the rotten dead. In the air shall they carry the virus to the breath of them that will not bow down to the name Lord God. Verse 11. Dias answered them, saying, so spoken, so shall these things be. I, the Lord your God, command. Send forth your generals and high captains, thus decreed, to each and every one sufficient armies to make patent these our high resolves. Into 3 great armies shall my legions be divided for the earth battles, one to Japheth, one to India, and one to Arabinia, and these regions lying west and north of the latter, though Osiris shall have chief command, and though Baal and Ashtaroth, ye twine so linked in love and one purpose, shall be the earth managers to Osiris' will. For your efficient service, behold, I have given you these high-raised generals and captains, Ja, Plutonia, Apolloia, Petorus, Hiram, Tichrono, Egypt, Ares, Yobi, Elijah, Aphrodite, Artemis, Ben, Aaron, Argo, Atstissel, Nadar, and Oib, besides Peter, Yaktarath, Haor, Abel, Sed, Josh, and Wab, who shall be the conquering spirits to play on both sides in battle, urging stubborn mortals onto religious feud, till both sides fall in death, or till one, to me, my gods, bow down in fear and reverence, and they shall sing their names in mortal ears day and night, and teach them to live in praise of the Lord your God, the Dais of heaven and earth, and to be most daring in the overthrow of Jehovah, most hated of gods. Verse 12. To thee, Tien, another third of my legion is committed to deal with the land of giants, and urge them on in the same way, to greatness or to death, doing honor and reverence to me and my kingdoms. High raised are thy generals, Waka, Hojoya, Okeanos, Zowawath, Hangli, Gochinwatugal, and Eragarath, besides Yamyam and Hirak, to Kakankat, Azeah, Lutzram, and Liwang, and others of high grade and power. Verse 13. And to thee, O Sudga, in like manner have I given another third of my legions to play battle with mortals for 1,000 years. Like Osiris and Tien, to set mortals up in war and move them one way and then another, and thus plunder them into each other's bloody arms and death, that they may learn to know of a truth they are but machines and playthings in the hands of angels and gods.